The miracle of the sea still stimulates. In deep, provoking psychedelic air, where a great body of salt is a high, as light burst from my sea solar plexus, I listen intently to surfaces, then angel lands haloed by human breath, once wounded on my old barren islands, bare of vegetation by the palm trees, recalling conversations word for word. The sea feels comfortable by expressions, by its gestures that are unsung and gray, with years shunned by shock-proof tourists like me, spilling life in seabeds, then sea battles, when returning to sea economies. My days created a creative block, seized by a raised ridge-shaped wave of hunger, where I am no one's souvenir but God's, in salt waters of Earth's inland bodies, while secrecy is the worm that eats souls. To be forgotten is a daily death, bound to surge into my bloodstream rising, where seas teach how to leash a volcano, riding it towards the cold light emerging, finding myself a streamed poet to haunt. The surging sea helps me flee its footnote, planting a perfect metaphor for growth, promising higher consciousness flooding, surging body awareness through gushing, drifting my muse in a body of leaves. I have known great sea body awareness, building a marine being by myself, working in an isolated tank life that still leaks out existence by ocean, where the samadhi tank is still with me. The squelching fountain is water portions of a poet who writes a winged epic about my mad rule over stolen land, where myth is a fountain of salt waters, forgotten with generous, useless gifts. I am dominated where seas cry out, waving its muse for those who are buried, crashing sea tombstones where mourners cast rods, weeping because salt is an honest gift for wretchedness of sea beats manliness. The turbulence of land rests its mimic, where the black moon shows humiliation, speaking masculine sorrow feminine, while talking the language of history when tonguing about my feminine side. I feel guilty watching my head nod out, vocalizing to be young forever, overthrowing any of graying gods, with untranslated papers mispronounced in last moments named for me and strangers. A bony fist vertebrae provides life in new words decayed like a fish consumed, eaten like those cooked gardens left behind, where wine is the fish of edible fish, as some spills onto slender body maps. My future trails of blood expands in salt, of no partitioners with real walls and doors, joining the sea like a good team player, while still doing things my own way in seas. But I am less threatened by islands now. My seas cry for its sensitivity, where poetic great bodies swim waters, as poets are clumsy ventriloquists by fish stories published in rhyming verse with catchy words as sea perils endure. Sweeping my words beneath my seascaped feet, I have been self-righteous for my own good, feeling bad I did not defend myself, for I am to be more than what I am, when I want to be more than I can be, while I do not try to earn approval. Disapproval still bothers me by seas, where my vices are older than my age, while intense rage is an aged passion wine, while a sum summarizing a summons, as the whole sea always hides hollow holes. Seas with greater beliefs are unending, reaching comet readers or court eunuchs, where I supply words for my own meaning, reading unbroken English language moons, dropping undivided light with remorse. My words replace windows with tapestries, in heavy cities like Jerusalem, crowed with crusaders, spending its fish blood by three lines cursing bloody words by seeds of its ancient trade root, resting by seas. My divine fish scriptures are just braggarts, while the old is old by world principle, wearing burning blood sea inside and out, where I was the divine sun's bastard, when I was an irrational coxman. I have steered promiscuity to seas, in voiceless sounds of enslaved compasses, then salty empires of my labor, where ship vibrations can burn on the wear, as seas are both message and messenger. I search defense that distracts from the past, inside the foundation between my legs, reading my history of genitals through sexed poetic hyperactive words, resting on its salt waters of the earth. My words are ocean disturbance angels, training through the sea's violin lessons, blessing me with assertiveness training in some kind of turbulent power play with tactics of concentrating on seas. Morning wakes up wearing the smell of fish or the holy underwear of its seas in a ventriloquist seance with its spiritual attempts at dead fish, receiving lives of spirits of the dead. My life is contrary to nature laws, as poets from a nearby star join me, landing my speech as therapists insist, when my language flows before being forced, wearing a fig leaf by the naked sea. My words used to be called my lovemaking, menacing sounds like imagination, while bribing God for erections of seas, where poetry practices scars of fish, and sea spectacles are condemnations.